cue for the music by ABBA, written by Benny Anderson and Bjorn Ulvaeus, two of the greatest songwriters of all time. Their catalog of songs is maybe 150 to 200 songs that everybody everywhere knows. In their prime, they were earning over £1 million a day. So here's Agnetha, Benny, Bjorn, and Annifrid, ABBA, 1983. Thank you for the music.
I'm nothing special. In fact, I'm a bit of a bore. If I tell a joke, you've probably heard it before. But I have a talent of wonderful things, 'cause everyone listens when I start to sing. I'm so grateful and proud. All I want is to sing it out loud.
So
ABBA with Thank You for the Music, and I'm thanking you for the music, and we're near the end of our run. We only have a few more shows to go before the end of the year. I'm very grateful to CBC because it's been a 16-year run doing Vinyl Path, and my son Tal, who does my research, says to me, do you know that we get letters from people saying, why do you call your show Vinyl Path? So let me explain this. 16 years ago, or before that, let's say 18 years ago, I lived on Salt Spring Island, and every Saturday night after dinner, I would just sit there with my guitar writing songs, and we'd listen to Danny Finkelman's 45s, which was on CBC at 7 o'clock every Saturday, and I was in Winnipeg. We grew up in Winnipeg together. I was doing a show at CBC, and he'd always come in, he wanted to be a DJ, so I've known him a long, long time. Then I heard he was retiring, and I thought, how could he retire? It's like so much fun playing records and music and talking. At the same time, I had a jazz album out, and I got asked to play a couple couple of my jazz songs on Stuart McLean's Vinyl Cafe, where he always had a couple of cool new upcoming Canadian artists doing one or two songs and help promote their music. So I went to do that, and I met the crew there. We got to chatting, and I said, you guys work with Danny Finkham? And they said, yeah. I said, how can he be retiring? And what are you guys going to put on? They said, we don't know what we're going to put on. I said, well, anybody can put on a show like his. And they looked at me and said, oh, why don't you try one? And I said, you've got to be kidding. And they said, no, why don't you try a show? And I said, well, what would I do? And they said, you can do whatever you want. You just pick your ideas. So I thought, gee, I'm going to try this, and I'll play all my old favorite records and tell my stories about the people whose music I'm playing. And it might be interesting to other people because these stories have never been printed or told because they're in my memory bank of me. And so I did a demo show, and then I thought of a name, and a lot of people apparently have not heard of the movie Spinal Tap, which is a parody movie, and it was a spoof of all rock and roll bands and how they make it, and how the drummer's always late, and the lead singer always has three girlfriends, and all that kind of stuff going on. And it's a very, very funny movie called Spinal Tap. And I thought, gee, I want to maybe call my show Vinyl Tap because I'm playing all my old vinyl. This was the thing, I was going to go through all my old records. So that was my shtick. And then I called Stuart McLean and I said, hey, I just got offered a show, and he knew about this because he was there when it was happening. I said, I've done a demo and they like it. I want to call my show Vinyl Tap. Can I use the word vinyl because there's a mix up with Vinyl Cafe? And he said, well, I don't know the word vinyl. Nobody does. So go ahead and good luck. So you can use it. So I became Randy's Vinyl Tap. My original logo was a tap, like an old faucet, and a drip coming out of it that was black. It was falling onto a round turntable, which was an LP going around, spinning around, or a 45 going around. So that's how we got the name Randy's Vinyl Tap. Let's continue with music, which is the whole show is all about.